This is One News with Simon Dallow and Wendy Petrie.
Tonight, our biggest quake in nearly 80 years. A family captures the scary moments while we catch up with the people rocked the hardest.
A view of the damage from the air. And is there a fear the next huge shake will hit closer to homes?
Our top judge calls for criminals to be let out of jail. Are her bosses happy with what she's saying?
And Michael Jackson on fire. We'll show you new video of the ad shoot that changed his life.
Kia ora, good evening. It's been more shake than shatter. The huge earthquake experts have been warning us about for years has struck.
It's 7.8 on the Richter scale. It's the biggest tremor for 78 years. Tonight we'll show you the places and the people affected the most, starting with the town in Southland that's 100 kilometres from the epicentre. John McDermott joins us from Tuatapere. John.
Well, hello, Simon. We're here in the bar at the Tuatapere pub where last night a quiet drink turned rather nasty. Like thousands of people in the south, the patrons here suddenly found themselves on an awful roller coaster.
In Queenstown, it was clean-up time.
The drinks, the fizzies and all that, they're all coming down like missiles.
No serious damage, just confusion as staff and customers try to work out what's going on.
Everything just started going ballistic, eh? It was really mad.
It's hard to spot, but as the quake hits, you can see bottles moving on the shelves.
Earthquake?
One central Otago family caught it all on camera.
You're right?
Yeah.
Still going, mate.
Oh, no.
Yeah, just watch, just in case, like, the lights blow up or something.
The children amazed as they watch the lights swing from the ceiling.
That's better. Mama, earthquake's bad.
At 7.8, this was New Zealand's biggest earthquake for nearly 80 years.
It was a bit scary, yes.
Something new, yeah.
it went for ages and it rolled rather than shook, and we were going to get out of there. It was pretty scary.
In Tuatapere, cracks in the masonry, groceries all over the floor, a night to remember.
It was moving sideways. It was the whole house just, it moves and you just wait for the whole windows to start breaking and the house to split. It was awful, it really was.
The earthquake's epicentre was up here in the fiords, and if we travel 100 kilometres down here in this direction, we find Tuatapere, way, way too close for many of the locals.
I just sort of started off sort of going one way, and at the end it sort of stopped and then just went opposite way altogether, which is a bizarre sort of a feeling when you're sitting there in a house and it's doing that.
At the pub, they'd hardly had time to draw breath before the Japanese television stations were on the line.
They didn't believe us that there were no injuries, no people. They thought the windows would have been blown out of the hotel, and they couldn't believe that we were just staying here.
Even the Prime Minister acknowledges a lucky escape.
Yeah, it's a massive earthquake, and I think New Zealand can sort of thank its lucky stars. I mean, there doesn't seem to be massive damage.
Damage inspection teams agree. Even the South Coast's historic Percy Byrne Viaduct surviving okay.
There's no apparent damage. We won't know any more until our engineers inspect the data we collected.
There are plenty of stories to tell. One Tiano man caught in the bath.
She was coming right up and over, over the edge, onto the floor and beginning to flow out the door there. So,
with aftershocks continuing all day, everyone is still on edge.
Speaking of those aftershocks, John, how many have there been?
Well, there have been a lot, Simon. I was in a shop just down the road here at lunchtime and you could certainly feel it shaking around. There have been hundreds of aftershocks, so many, in fact, that they won't be counting them until next week. The Earthquake Commission says that it's received about 250 claims for damages, nearly all of those claims for minor damage, and that certainly has to be the big story here. Such a huge earthquake with so little damage, and that's something that's got the geologists really scratching their heads.
Thank you very much, John. John McDermott reporting from Tuatapere. And the Fiordland quake is among a cluster of the second largest recorded in New Zealand since European settlement. The biggest was the 8.2 magnitude quake in Wairarapa in 1855. A big jolt in Murchison in 1929 left 17 dead. But the deadliest in 1931 killed more than 250 people in Napier and Hastings. Three people died in the 1968 Inangahua quake, which caused widespread damage. Also destructive because of its shallowness was the 1987 Edgecombe earthquake.
So what's the chance of an even bigger quake now striking our shaky isles? Lauralee Mason has gone to the experts to find out.
Sichuan province, a 7.8 magnitude quake claimed 10,000 lives. Pakistan, 4 years ago, a 7.6 shake, 79,000 dead. And Kobe, Japan, 6.8 on the Richter scale. All caused major destruction. But mercifully, not last night in Resolution Island, Fiordland, thanks to the remote location.
It was quite shallow, which suggests that there would be a lot of strong shaking, but because it's not in a soft sediment basin like we had in Hawke's Bay, the ground won't shake as much.
Scientists are now installing temporary seismometers to pick up aftershocks. One concern, that last night's shake may have significantly disrupted the Alpine fault line.
And there's certainly a possibility that the earthquake on this fault has actually loaded another fault and made another fault in the area more apt to rupture.
They're on the lookout too for damage. The 2003 magnitude 7 quake in Fiordland triggered 200 landslides.
Okay, so we've got an earthquake shake table here.
So what would last night's quake have felt like? We went to Canterbury University's Civil Engineering Department to find out.
The record that we're going to subject you to is the Arthur's Pass earthquake of a few years ago.
That shake was 6.3, the most this simulator can safely handle with a human on board.
So if you just hop up there.
It's quite an unusual feeling. You're actually not quite sure which way to lean. Your natural instinctive reaction is to grab hold of something and hit the deck.
If the quake had happened in central city Wellington, however,
you'd probably expect to sort of see something of about that sort of movement in an earthquake of that sort of magnitude.
Even more reason to be glad the big one hit not here, but in such a remote area. Lauralee Mason, One News.
While the jolt was felt as far north as Bay of Plenty, it also quickly became headline news around the world.
Very powerful earthquake. They've issued a tsunami warning.
That alert also prompting warnings across the Tasman to stay away from beaches in New South Wales, a call ignored by some.
It was a bit disappointing.
Well, you were actually hoping a big wave would hit?
Yeah, well, I mean, something, you know, some sort of wave, some sort of action, you know.
The biggest wave clocked by the Pacific Tsunami Centre, a mere 17 centimetres higher than usual. And you can find many more personal stories on the big jolt by clicking onto our website, tvnz.co.nz.